Welcome to the broadcast. Here we are taking a look at the Hofner violin bass, also known as the Beatles bass. Let's take a look right real quick from the start. We're not messing around here. We tell the facts as they appear. As you notice, it basically has old style guitar tuners. It has a plastic nut. I filed it down. I was afraid to do too much without a backup in case something broke. And if you do not file it, I would at least apply some graphite material, because when you adjust the tuning, you know, it seems to dig in with, well, also, the first thing you gotta do is get rid of these round wound strings and get yourself a set of the Beatles bass flat wound strings. The gauge here is 96 to like 40 or something. It makes a big difference, especially if you're doing Paul McCartney type of bass lines, a lot of sliding up and down. These strings, you know, they gotta cut costs, you know, in some areas, because it's very inexpensive. Made in China, but they did a very good job. It survived a disastrous event at the UPS hub, where they held it for a day or two. I guess they were just checking it out to make sure it was one piece. But it looks great. I mean, the neck is pretty beefy. Let's see what we got here. Now, you want a quarter sawn neck. People might not agree with me on that, but quarter sawn, for example, like this, where there's like 20 vertical lines. You know, you want a whole bunch of lines like that. It's, you know, much more stable. That's equivalent to like when Ibanez does those necks that have strips of wood. That actually makes it a very stable neck. But here, instead of like three strips of wood, you have like 20. All right, what do we got over here? Is a neck joint visible? I don't know. But you can see it's got a couple lines, which is good. It's not a completely flat sawn. And I mean, apparently it's wood. It survived quite a bit of roughhousing. Okay, what's the other thing? The neck was pretty straight. The relief was a little much, but I mean, it was definitely good. There were only a few frets that were not pretty out of whack, but that needed filing and sanding. And after doing that, the 12th fret, the string height at the 12th fret is very, it's in the Fender, what do you call, a custom shop level. That required lowering the bridge. As a result of that, you get the screw sticking out, so you want to file that down. Also, the saddles are, you know, these little skimpy things. If you play aggressively, it's going to pop out, so you may have to file those. What else we got here? The intonation is pretty good. Remember, if it's sharp when you fret a note, because intonation is about the open string versus fretted string. So let's say you don't play the 12th fret. You play around here, you got to intonate it so these are in tune the best they can be. And it's, even with this very primitive floating bridge, it's possible to do it. You can move this on an angle, you can do some sort of tweaks there. And if once you get the flat wound strings and set up, then I would, if this was for me, I would like get some Elmer's glue and do the intonation so it locks in place. And that's about it. The sound chamber seems to be here. You know, it says hollow body, but the sound comes from there. It's very acoustic. I don't know if you can hear that. But, you know, it's definitely a piece of imitation history. But it's pretty cool. And it works. Short scale. If you're used to a regular scale, like 34, and we're talking about the distance between the nut and the average saddle. This is actually like 30 inches and a half. Now here's some serious saddles where it can withstand a tremendous amount of activity. Also, you might notice that the fretboard is wider. It's a little narrower here. That might be a good thing if you want to do chords up there. This particular body, I might even put on eBay and get a G4 from Warmoth, because going up, I like to play this upper register, and this thing, I can't, you know, doesn't allow for that. But this, look at that. There's the E, right? Where's the U? The E over here, it's like tough to get. But here, look at that. There's the E. So anyway, it's I was impressed. It does require someone that you know or yourself to make it more playable with certain means to do the setup. So that's something to keep in mind. But anyway, okay, take care, bye.